Mr. Welch.
Director Mueller, did you find there was no collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia?
Well, we don't use the word collusion. The word we usually use is not collusion, but one of the other terms that that fills in when collusion is not used. In any event, we decided not to use the word collusion, in as much as it has no relevance to the criminal law arena.
The term is conspiracy that you prefer to use?
That's a conspiracy, exactly right.
You help me, I'll help you.
Thank you.
There's an agreement. Thank you. And in fact, you had to then make a charging decision after your investigation, where unless there was enough evidence to prove beyond a reasonable doubt, you wouldn't make a charge, correct?
Generally, that's the case.
But making that decision does not mean your investigation failed to turn up evidence of conspiracy.
Absolutely correct.
And in fact, I'll go through some of the significant findings that your exhaustive investigation made. You found, as I understand it, that from May 2016 until the end of the campaign, campaign chairman Mr. Manafort gave private polling information to Russian agents, correct?
Correct.
Can you speak into the microphone?
Yep, I will. My apologies.
Thank you. And your investigation found that in June 2016, Donald Trump Jr. made an arrangement to meet at Trump Tower along with Jared Kushner and others, expecting to receive dirt on the Hillary Clinton campaign, correct?
Correct.
And you found in your investigation that in July 27th, candidate Trump called on Russia to hack Hillary Clinton's email, something that for the first time they did about 5 hours later, correct?
That's correct.
And you also found that on August 2nd, Mr. Manafort met with a person tied to Russian intelligence, Mr. Kalimnik, and gave him internal campaign strategy, aware that Russia was intending to do a misinformation social media campaign, correct?
I'm not certain of the tie there.
But the fact of that meeting, you agree with?
The fact of the meeting took place is accurate.
In your investigation, as I understand it, also found that in late summer of 2016, the Trump campaign, in fact, devised its strategy and messaging around WikiLeaks releases of materials that were stolen from the Democratic National Committee, correct?
Is that from the report?
Yes. It's according to Mr. Gates.
Yes.
Yes, thank you. And you also talked earlier about the finding in your investigation that in September and October of 2016, Donald Trump Jr. had email communications with WikiLeaks, now indicted, about releasing information damaging to the Clinton campaign, correct?
True.
So,
true.
All right. So I understand you made a decision, prosecutorial decision, that this would not rise to proof beyond a reasonable doubt. But I ask if you share my concern. And my concern is, have we established a new normal from this past campaign that is going to apply to future campaigns, so that if any one of us running for the U.S. House, any candidate for the U.S. Senate, any candidate for the presidency of the United States, aware that a hostile foreign power is trying to influence an election, has no duty to report that to the FBI or other authorities?
Well, I hope.
Go ahead.
I hope this is not new normal, but I fear it is.
And would, in fact, have the ability, without fear of legal repercussion, to meet with agents of that foreign entity hostile to the American election?
I'm sorry, what is the question?
Is that an apprehension that you share with me?
Yes.
And that there would be no repercussions whatsoever to Russia if they did this again? And as you stated earlier, as we sit here, they're doing it now. Is that correct?
You're absolutely right.
Do you have any advice to this Congress as together what we should do to protect our electoral system and accept responsibility on our part to report to you or your successor when we're aware of hostile foreign engagement in our elections?
I would say the basis, the first line of defense really is the ability of the various agencies who have some piece of this to not only share information, but share expertise, share targets, and use the full resources that we have to address this problem.
Thank you, Director Mueller. I yield back.